So this is basically a simple scenario. So far what we discussed on the network side, network topology, if you recollect the initial sessions what we discussed. Okay. I have one physical host. Okay, how many cables that I can connect? I have two cables for management. I have another two cables for production. Okay, I have another two cables for vMotion. I have another two cables for fault tolerance. I have another two cables for backup. Okay, and apart from that, imagine I'm not using iSCSI, I'm using fiber channel. So another two cables for FC cables. These two are FC cables. This is different. Okay, so what, how it looks like, let me show you. Imagine one ESXi host. You have storage. Okay. Like this, you have multiple data stores or multiple LANs created in SAN. Okay. And here you will have two switches. Switches. How it works? You will have two HBA cards here. One HBA card will be connected like this. Another HBA card will be connected like this. Okay. And on the storage, you have controller one and controller two. Two controllers are there. Okay. And they can manage all the storage. So from controller one, at the picture, you'll go one cable, controller two, one cable. Again, from controller one, one cable to this switch, and from controller two, one cable to this switch. These two are fiber channel switches. Means, if this system want to get some storage, these are the cabling, what we can say, network cabling diagram, you can say switch one and switch two. Any confusion here? Hello?
No sir.
This is
no sir.
HBA one, HBA host bus adapter one. This is host bus adapter two. Two cables, fiber channel one and fiber channel two. Two cables will be connected. And if you really want more high availability, you can place some more cables like this, so that another set of high availability will be in the picture. But it's okay. You have high availability configured over here. Okay, to get storage. Now you got a storage. You want to log in into this ESXi. How you log in? You need a management kernel port. What you will do? You will create a kernel port here. You will create one standard switch. You will create a kernel port and you will attach these two cables. When you are saying two cables, do you think both the cables will go sit in one switch or two switches? Why you know two cables, high availability, and you took two cables and put it on the same switch. If the switch is gone, two cables are waste. What do you recommend?
Switches. Two switches.
Right? Everywhere two switches. Please be careful. I don't want to repeat this again and again. If I am using two cables, means what is the significance of two cables? High availability. But if you think that these two cables are connected in one switch, what's the point of connecting two cables? If the switch is gone, both the cables are gone. Right? So it is always two switches. Okay. And these two switches on the back end, you have firewall. firewall HA1, and you have another firewall. Firewall HA, two firewalls, both are connected to each other, primary and secondary. So what I will do, I will connect one cable to here and one cable to here. So this is your data center boundary. And if someone is, sorry, let me draw something differently. This is your data center boundary. If someone is trying to access from outside, they can come and hit. Both are having load balancing, right? Hit here, one request, it will go like this, another request will go like this. Anyway, it will go like, fair enough on this concept. Okay, now this kernel port will be used to login only, no other traffic, login, log off, management. Now I'm saying I have a distributed port groups here. Why you need a distributed port groups? VLAN 10, VLAN 20, VLAN 30 for virtual machines. So if I have a three different virtual machines here, okay, place them in a correct position, proper network configuration. So for what we discussed, and I said two cables. When I say two cables, again, you have to make a judgment saying two different switches. And these two switches, if customer and me are using both are using the same firewall, it will also go and sit in the same firewall. No, this is different. This is my own firewall. Customer has a different firewalls and he is paying for those firewalls. In the sense, customer is paying extra money for his own firewalls. Okay, now I will connect this network to customer firewall. See, firewall, customer firewalls. So if a customer is trying to access the machines, he will come and traffic will go and he'll be able to access the machine. Imagine I have one more host, and I have one more port group, two cables. One cable will come and sit here, another cable will come and sit here, because these two are the big switches. Understood? If I have a 64 host, same configuration, replicate. I'm just demonstrating for one host. You can replicate these switches are connected with multiple other hosts in the same room. Now, what is this? The green one? Yeah, this is for kernel port vMotion, the green one. Again, it is connected to one switch like this. And does it go to firewall? No need to go to firewall, or it doesn't have any requirement to send the data to firewall, because vMotion is used for DRS, right? This virtual machine will communicate, and I will have one more host, and I have one more kernel port for vMotion, and it also has two cables. These two cables will come and sit in this same switch, so that this host and this host can exchange the data like this. Okay, can I put it something different way? This is customer facing, right? This is customer facing. So I will create switch here. This, imagine this is kernel port. This is kernel port, and it is going to two switches. I have two switches. Okay, and I have one more host. Imagine two more cables here. These two cables will come and understood? I have one more kernel port here. This is for vMotion. So if I want to bring this VM, this will communicate via this, and it will go and migrate to here, and machine will be created here automatically, or machine will be moved here automatically. Migrate or vMotion, live migration. Understood? For that, another two cables, another two cables, and similarly, FT logging, fault tolerance logging, these two cables. Okay, yes, another set of fault tolerance logging also has another set of two cables on the back end and two more switches. Or, yeah, let's make it as simple. Don't want to confuse. And this is also having fault tolerance from here, two cables to this switch. Understood? And the backup. If I want to take a backup of all these VMs, I will create one more port group, not a kernel port group. These port groups for customer firewall. This port group is for backup. Like this. And these two cables will go to one switch. On the switch other side, one big server will sit, backup server. It will dump the data here. It will not go to firewall. These two will not go to firewall. How many cables will go to firewall? Four cables will go to firewall for production. Rest of the six cables, they will be used in internal purpose. And two more cables for fiber channel. How many? 12 cables are needed here in this picture. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Two FC cables, remaining all Ethernet 1GB. No, customer is so costly. Okay, fine. 1GB, 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 10GB, 10GB. This is 10GB switch. This is 10GB switch, and this has some good connected firewall, and it has fiber connectivity to his office. You getting how it works? Okay, if it is too high level. Okay, if you can recollect these points when you are doing in real time, watch this video once again, you'll definitely get what exactly it is, how exactly it is configured, and how you can manage your traffic. You understood how many kernel ports, why you need these many cables, why you need these many kernel ports and all?
Yes.
Any questions on this network aspect? Sunil?
No, sir.
Vivek?
No, sir. Hello?
Yeah, tell me. Any questions?
No, sir.
Looks like Kichdi, it's okay, but you'll understand when you are really working in real time, on if you follow the instructions carefully. This is how it works, and you can minimize and you can stretch the number of connections based on the customer requirement. Okay, I don't want to use vMotion FT separately, so I will use same switch. I don't want to use management vMotion and FT. Three different kernel ports. I will use same kernel port to route the traffic in a different purposes. In the same way for a different purposes. Clear?
Yes.
All right. Yeah. Let me stop here. It's a simple scenario, but I hope this will help you to understand what we covered so far up to today's session from network onwards. In this scenario, you have all standard switches, one distributed switch, couple of kernel ports, and fiber channel connectivity. How things got portrayed in a single view. Okay, let me stop here. We'll catch up tomorrow, same time.